हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू इंडियन जुडिशियल सर्विस। टुडेज वी आर डीलिंग हियर क्वेश्चन नंबर 81 टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 100। दिस इज द पार्ट 6 ऑफ टॉप 400 एमसीक्यू ऑफ कोड ऑफ क्रिमिनल प्रोसीजर 1973 प्रोसीजर। नाउ क्वेश्चन नंबर 81, द पावर टू इन डायरेक्ट इन्वेस्टिगेशन अंडर सेक्शन सब सेक्शन 3 ऑफ सेक्शन 56 ऑफ सीआरपीसी कैन बी एक्सरसाइज बाय। So here, power to direct investigation. So in subsection 3 of section 56 is option A, magistrate, session judge, both A and B, either A or B. So in this question, the power to direct investigation is only to those magistrate who has taken the cognizance of offense under section 190. So according to 190, the first class magistrate can take the cognizance. So here answer is option A, magistrate can direct the investigation. Now question number 82, subsection 2 of section 56 of CRPC take care and cure any irregularity in the conducting of investigation by police officer. Any illegality in the conducting of investigation by police officer, both A and B, and only A, not B. So here answer is option C is correct here, both A and B. So any irregularity in the conducting of investigation and any illegality in conducting of investigation by the police officer, PO. Now question number 83, under section 159 of CRPC, a preliminary inquiry into the commission of offence can be conducted by the magistrate having a jurisdiction to take a cognizance, option B here, by any magistrate subordinate to a magistrate having jurisdiction under the order of such magistrate, option C, by police officer, option D, only A, not B. So here answer is option D, only A and B. So now question number 54, the power under section 159 of CRPC can be exercised by the magistrate when police is still investigating the case. When the police decide not to investigate the case, when police has filed a report under section 173 of CRPC. In 173, police send a report to the magistrate. So, in option D, all of the above. So, in this question, read again here question. The power under section 159 of CRPC can be exercised by the magistrate. So here answer is option B, when the police decide not to investigate the case. So the under section 159, magistrate use their power to instruct the investigation if the police investigation or preliminary inquiry, if the police is not decided that he cannot conduct the investigation. So question number 85, the power to require attendance of person acquainted with the facts and circumstance of the case under section 160 of CRPC require by notice by telephone, notice in writing, either A or B, both A and B. So in this question, answer is here, notice in writing. The power to inquire the attendance of witness, the police officer having the power to require the attendance of a person acquainted with the fact and circumstance, a person who is familiar with this fact and circumstance. So in this case the police officer have power to invite for examination. So in this, and such invitation should be in writing. So option B is correct here. क्वेश्चन नंबर 86, इन्वेस्टिगेटिंग ऑफिसर अंडर सेक्शन 160 ऑफ सीआरपीसी कैन नॉट रिक्वायर द अटेंडेंस एट द प्लेस अदर देन द प्लेस ऑफ रेसिडेंट. अ मेल हु हैज अंडर द एज ऑफ 18, अ मेल हु हैज अंडर द एज ऑफ 16, अ वुमेन और आइदर ए और बी और सी. सो हियर आंसर इज ऑप्शन सी, ओनली वुमेन हियर. सो इन द केस when the police officer invite the person for examination under section 160, so he cannot invite the woman into the police office, police station, and he is liable to take the examination of such woman at their home or their own choice, woman's choice. So there are some following exceptions here. So according to 160, following persons are not liable to present before the court at police station if the child, male child below the age of 15 year. Now second person here, if the male person is above the age 65 year, male person above age of 65 year. Now third one here, woman. Fourth here, physically or mentally weaker person. These persons are not liable to present before the police at police station. There is a duty of police or police officer in charge of investigation should take the examination at their residence. Now question number 87, the investigating officer under section 160 of CRPC cannot require the attendance of a male at the place other than the place of resident. Who is? Option A here, age of 16 year, under the age of, sorry here, option A, under the age of 15 year, option B, under the age of 16 year, option C, under the age of 18 year, option D, under the age of 21 year. So here option A I already expressed, and those persons is only examined at their resident. So the one of them here, the under the age of their male person, if under the age of 15 year, his examination is in their residence by the investigating officer. According to section 166, the examination of witness only conducted by the investigating officer. This word is very important, investigating, not police officer, other police officer, not officer in charge. Here only investigating officer. Now question number 88, a trial on a police report initiated by the breach of mandatory provision relating to investigation is vitiate and liable to be set aside. Vitiate and liable is not vitiate and cannot be set aside unless the legality in the investigation can be shown to have brought about a miscarriage of justice. Is not vitiate and cannot be set aside at all, either B or C. So here answer is option B is correct. The trial on police report initiated by the breach of mandatory provision. So if the police report is initiated by the breach of mandatory provision that relating to the investigation is not vitiate and cannot be set aside unless legality in the investigation can be shown to have brought about a miscarriage of justice. Now question number 89, the preposition R, the delay in dispatch of FIR is not a circumstance with which can throw out the prosecution case in its entirety. The delay in dispatch of FIR is a circumstance which can throw out the prosecution case in its entirety. The extraordinary delay in sending the FIR is a circumstance which provides the legitimate basis of suspecting, they are very important word here, suspecting that FIR was recorded much later than the stated date and hour, and affording a sufficient time to the prosecution to introduce the improvement. Which of the following is a correct respect of the aforesaid proposition? So in this question here, option A is true, option B and second and third are false. No, here option first and third are true and option second is false here. So option B is correct here. Read again these options. Option first and third are true. So delay in dispatch of FIR is not circumstance which can throw out the prosecution case in its entirety. And second, third here, point important. These two points are correct here. An extraordinary delay sending the FIR is circumstance which provide a legitimate basis for a suspecting that FIR was recorded much later than stated date and hour, and affording a sufficient time to the prosecution to introduce improvement. So if the FIR is delay, there is a suspecting, but such FIR is not illegitimate. It is legitimate, but the suspect, their credibility is reduced here in the proceeding. Question number 90. Section 159 of CRPC empower a magistrate. So here question ask here, according to section 190 of CRPC, empower the magistrate to restrain the police investigation and order a magistratorial inquiry when investigation of cognizable offense by police is already in process. Option B, to other magistratorial inquiry into a cognizable offense only in those cases in which the police decide not investigate. Option C, to order a magistratorial inquiry into a cognizable offense where investigation by police is already in process. Option D, either A, either B or C. So in this question, according to section 59, so section 59 deal with the power to hold investigation. Section 159 deal with power to hold investigation and preliminary inquiry. So here the magistrate having a power where the police officer is decided that there is no need of investigation. In such case, the police, your magistrate having a power to instruct the police to start investigation, or he also giving the order to their subordinate or himself taking or starting the preliminary inquiry. Preliminary inquiry is those inquiry which is started from before the trial. And if that inquiry is after the trial, such inquiry is a proper inquiry. And if the before the in trial, such inquiry is preliminary inquiry. So in this question, the police officer is rejected. The police officer decide that not to investigate the case. So option C, B is correct here, according to section question number 90. Now question number 92, section 160. CRPC authorizes a police officer to summon a person as a witness, summon a person for the production of document, summon a person for production of an articles, all of the above. So here answer is, according to section 60, the police officer have power to any person in written order to present before for examination. So question number 92, answer here, option A, summon a person as a witness. Because after this section, section 161, police take examination of witness here. So now this is the previous section of the previous stage of the examination of witness by the police officer. And I already expressed that, and those persons are not liable to present before the police officer at the their police station. And in such case, the police officer's duty to take examination as their residence. Now question number 93. A person can be summoned as a witness under section 160 of CRPC by police officer, by station house officer, by investigating officer. Here important word here. Option D, any of the above. So in this question, option C, I already explained there, the order to present a person before the police officer for examination is only given by the investigating officer. And if such person is reject the order of written order of the investigating officer, shall be liable for under sex punishment under section 174 of IPC, because he is disobeying the order of public servant. So he is liable under section 174 of IPC. Now question number 94. A person who failed to attend on being served with an order under section 160 of CRPC, an investigating officer is liable to prosecute under. So I already expressed here, option B is correct here, 174 IPC. Now question number 95. The lying of trap is a part of investigating inquiry, preliminary inquiry and trial. So here the lying of trap, it is help to find out the evidence. So it is the it is a part of investigation. So answer option A is correct here. Question number 96. Section 161 of CRPC provide the case Section 161 of CRPC cover the case information received by police before the commencement of investigation, after the commencement of investigation, after the commencement conclusion of trial, both A and B. So in this question, the examination of witness under section 161 is after the commencement of examination, sorry, after the commencement of investigation. So option B is correct here. Who among the following is not a police officer? So enforcement officer investigating the case under FERA is not a police officer. An officer investigate with power under NDPS Act. Officer of Railway Protection Force, and all of the above. So here answer is all of the above. So there are two important terms here, FERA and NDPS. So here first of important word here, FERA, F-E-R-A, FERA. FERA means here Foreign Exchange Regulation. This is Act. This was Act. So now it is changed in FEMA. So but in previous time it is FERA. So Foreign Exchange Regulation Act. So it is FERA. Now we are dealing here NDPS. NDPS. It is here narcotic drug and psychotropic. Psychotropic substance. tans, TANCE, act, it is also act. So narcotic drugs and psychotropic substance act, it is NDPS. So who among us the following is not a police officer? All those who are taking investigation under the following, under these given acts, are not a police officer. Question number 98. An unjustified and unexplained long delay on the part of investigation officer is unjustified, first here, and unexplained. Long delay in a part of investigation officer in recording the statement of a material witness and would we render the evidence of such witnesses unreliable, unadmissible, inadmissible and unreliable? Only B, not A. So here answer is unreliable. It is admissible, but reliability is very low here. So it is unreliable. So answer is A here. Question number 99. The statement made under section 161 of CRPC during investigation of a cross case is always admissible in the main case, may be admissible in the main case, here always, here main, and in at all admissible in main case, admissible in the main case with the leave of the court. So here answer is option C, not at all admissible in main case. Question number 100. The refusal to answer a question put to a witness under section 161 of CRPC is an offense under section 176 IPC, section 179 IPC, section 187 IPC, neither A nor B nor C. So it is clear here, it is punishable under section 179 IPC. There is some important fact here. According to section 161, the examination of witness by the police officers, such person shall be bound to answer the question of police officer, investigating officer, if he is not giving the proper and correct answer, he shall be liable under section 179 of IPC. If he is not present before the police officer, he is liable under section 174. But if he is not giving the answer of the police officer, answer of the questions of police officer, he is liable under section 179. Not present, 174. Not giving answer, 179. By the witness. Witness is different from the accused. Here is no accused. It is here witness. So thank you for watching this video. And if you like this video, please click on like button. Please share this video to your friends and relatives. And please subscribe our channel. Thank you.